Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here tonight. I got my pumpkin with me. And
showing my face. Right?
I'm going to do an unboxing of some herbs and kind of give you a breakdown. I've had several questions about what which herbs or which crystals are for what. So it's going to be a two-part. I'm going to do a crystal live later. Hi, Anzi. Hi, Little Bad Wolf. Hi, Amber. Anyone else I missed?
Can you ask if it's laggy? Because, I had my phone as well out.
Are we echoing or laggy? You have to mute your phone, Pumpkin.
It's muted.
Okay.
Don't worry.
We sound okay? And everything look okay?
Oh, there goes our cat.
Someone in chat, let me know. Awesome. Thank you, Levi Wolf. Okay, I'm going to put the company in the description after the live. But, before I got to get to this, there's something I wanted to do last live, but I thought that Sarah, my mod, had left early. So I don't know if Sarah's in here tonight or not, but she got me a gift and I wanted to show it. It's super sweet. Super, super sweet and thoughtful. Untangle it. It's all tangled. I'll show you in a second, Pumpkin.
No, I'm saying I'll be showing my face later.
Yes, we'll show you. We'll show you in your cute little dress, Pumpkin.
Woo!
It's an evil eye. So it's got a bunch of evil eyes going down it. It's got an evil eye hanging from the bottom. But my other mod, Little Bad Wolf, was showing off her evil eye. And I had said I didn't have one, and I'd been wanting one. And she surprised me with that. It's really delicate. So I have to be careful whenever I do wear it. I absolutely love it. And thank you, Sarah, again. Okay, so into the unboxing. Are you looking at chat? Amzie said hi. I wish Amzie could have met her when she was down.
Thank you. I know.
Oh, it smells so good. It smells so good.
Thank you for the compliment. I know it's true. Just messing. Now I sound like I have an ego. I'm just making a joke.
So I'm going to read what the description of them from here, from the little booklet thing that came with them. Hi, Sassy. Now, girl. Serby is so sweet. She is very much a sweetheart. No, I don't want to bag on them. I'm going to do ASMR. I'm trying to jump them out in here. The cat was hanging around. He wanted to smell some of them, but I guess he bailed out.
He get a drink of water. He needs a break.
I'm so excited to do things with these. So excited. Okay, let's see. Let's go over lavender first. So lavender's pretty self-explanatory. Everyone, I think, knows lavender's for calming effects. You can put it under your pillow, put it in your bath or your tea, or even lemonade.
Your feet.
It's good in lemonade. It says it's the top herb for protection against evils. Use lavender to ward off evil spirits or create purification spells. Let's see what the next one is. Peppermint. Oh, are they going to be all mixed up? Oh, nice. They're going to be mixed up. So we'll skip. How am I going to do this? And a marigold right there. Okay. We got marigold, which is that flower like in the fall, the orange flower. It says the marigold flower. So it's the flower they use in this. It looks like it has the seeds to it, too. It says it's for protection, psychic powers, and lucid dreaming. So if anyone's trying to, I know a few other things.
I haven't told
a lucid dream means that you are aware that you are dreaming. Like you're in your dream and you're aware that you're dreaming. So then you can control the direction of the dream.
Is it like goggles people have for like lucid dreams?
I don't know what that is, Pumpkin. What goggles?
No, like there's these weird glasses people have now that like you can control your lucid dreams. Like
I'm new to that. It's something from TikTok.
Yeah.
Oh, of course.
There's kids.
All my 14-year-old's education comes from TikTok now.
The internet knows everything.
Because this is Feverfew. So this is a flower. It's like, looks like a tiny daisy. And I was always warned as a kid to be careful of picking the Feverfew flowers because they could have chiggers on them, kind of like that mother-in-law's lace. So it says, Feverfew can be used in spells for health, love, protection, cleansing, and purification. They kind of all smell the same when I smell them. Marigold. Let's see. My evil eye bracelet is my daily good luck charm. I have to have it on. Here, why don't you come click some of these so that the comments go up top.
There's only two people watching.
So there's only two the other day, and it there was more in there. Here, come click some of these so they'll go up at the top. Do you know how to do it?
No, I don't know how to stream. I only know how to stream on Twitch.
No, come here.
Twitch.com, Strawberry.
You go beside. You can drop your stuff later. You go beside it, and then you hit show. See? So you go there. Yeah, and then it should pop up on the screen. It should. Let's see.
Edge of my case.
Everything's super laggy. If that doesn't work. Yeah, there it goes. It just takes a second.
Okay, sorry for the lag.
I think that's just StreamYard, what StreamYard does. Let's look.
Please don't step on me. I'm right here.
Next one. So after I get through this, then we'll have Abbie wants to play a game of Guess That Song.
And then the winner
on her
gets
keyboard.
I would like to explain. Let me explain.
Go ahead.
So we're going to play Guess the Song, and whoever guesses the most gets a custom painting from me or a gift card, right?
Yeah, if they don't want to give their address.
Yeah, that.
If you don't want to share your address, then... Well, these are on the back.
Like, any size canvas you want. Like, you can have a... If I still have any left, like a 2-inch by 2-inch to a... what is it called? Darn it. I think it's like... 6-inch by a foot.
You have a lot of different canvases.
Yes.
And then you're going to let them pick what they want you to paint?
Yeah, you can paint. Well, you ask me to paint whatever you want.
Okay, this one is vervain. Have never heard of vervain before. It just looks like a bunch of stems and big seeds, like large seeds. And it says, vervain's a good health herb for spell pouches, for love or protection, encourages clear vision and creativity. It was sacred to Diana, the god, the goddess of the hunt, and its planet is Venus, and its elements Earth. That's neat. They don't do that with every one of them. Get the planet and the element. That's neat. And that's vervain. So now I'm going to be on a mission to learn each one of them's ruling planet or star and its element. Let's see. Argamon. I don't even know how to spell this one. I mean, pronounce this one. Argamoni.
I think.
Argamoni.
Why are you asking me that?
So lots of green and leaves, and this one is stems. It says Argamoni is a good herb for protection.
Hello,
it's
Harmony.
A hex breaker. And it's good for reversing spells. So I'll be using that one. Definitely be using that one. Probably tonight. Well, I want to wait. I actually want to wait till the full moon.
Somebody says hello. Hello.
Hi, Harmony. Thanks for being here. We're going over herbs and what they're good for. Kind of doing like an unboxing. And then my pumpkin's going to do a guess that song on a keyboard for a prize.
And I'm just going to say real quick, I'm not that good, and I'm nervous,
Stop.
So it might sound a little bit off, but you'll still understand.
She's just gotten into the keyboard.
I've been playing for 6 years.
She's just gotten really into it in like the last 6 months. So this cinnamon, and it's like tiny little wood chunks of cinnamon. So cinnamon is, it says submerge yourself in a cinnamon bath for money. Also use cinnamon for protection, love, healing, staunching blood, and luck. Just cinnamon. Oops, sorry if I didn't scratch
fine,
you.
Fine.
You can pull some of the other comments up on the top.
I know.
Got jasmine. I love jasmine. That's so pretty.
I know what jasmine.
What's jasmine good for? fucking.
No, I mean, I said I know a Jasmine. I don't know what Jasmine is.
It says, in the witch's pantry, Jasmine is available as dried flowers and as a scented oil. The dried yellow-white petals do not hold much fragrance and are instead used for their symbolic power. Jasmine tea is made by infusing green or white leaves of jasmine. Okay, so it's excellent for divination. I might have to get some jasmine from an oil burner for when I do my my readings. The diffuser I have going when I do my readings. That's my element of water I use now. I put moon water in it. And whichever oil. Okay. Rosemary.
I don't know how to respond to this.
What is it? Okay. I need to bathe in some cinnamon here. I think we all need to bathe in cinnamon. And staunching, it says staunching blood. I don't know what that means. Does that mean to get blood to stop bleeding? Nurse Jen in here? What does staunching blood mean? I got Rosemary.
Like off-brand stitch.
I love cooking with Rosemary, except for, like, I have to really grind down the pieces. I don't like when I bite into big chunks of Rosemary.
What's that, babies?
It's like the needles of it.
What's the dog doing? The dog's in the tent.
So it says, Rosemary is the most typical herb for protection or love spell. It also has a soothing scent that can be used for various purposes. Whenever we have like are congested and we do a steam bath or, you know, go in and have a shower and breathe in the steam or do a pot, you know, with the towel over our head, we put rosemary in it and it helps a lot. Motherwort. There's one herb here in the mountains I've been looking for a really long time. A plant. And it's the Iroquois, which is the type of Native American I am. The Iroquois used it for divination. And it's called cut leaf toothwort. And so in the Appalachians, for every plant that's medicinal, there's usually a plant that looks very similar, but has like one or two characteristics that's different. And it's poisonous. Like, it'll be toxic. And I found the toxic, I found the toxic variations of it, but I've not found cutleaf toothwort yet. And I've been looking for it since I was pregnant with Abby. So over 14 years. So this is mugwort. It has some little green flowers in it. And then the stems. It says, or mother's wort, sorry. Mother's wort, it's a protective herb. It's a good use in your charms that fight back against hostile magic, and it is also useful in spells to dispel depression. So I wonder if it'd be good like in a sachet, like under your pillow if you were depressed. I'll have to try some of that. Let's see that. Colts. That's interesting looking. This one's interesting looking. Let's see, where's it at? Okay. Let's see if y'all can see it good. Looks like this one's probably the root or the bulb or the root and the bulb. That's what it looks like. It's called colt's foot. And it actually looks like a little foot, like a little hoof. It says colt's foot is one of the earliest flowers to bloom just in time for the embolic season, which is now. Well, we're coming to the end. We're going into Estrar, but. It can be used in love sachets to attune your soul and vision to love's energy. Oh, so it's supposed to put the frequency, give you the vibration of love's energy. It's an herb that inspires peace and has divinatory applications, as the leaves can be soaked to induce visions. Uh-oh. I don't see any of the leaves in here. It says you can soak the leaves of this colt's foot to induce visions. According to Miss Google, staunching blood is to stop the flow of blood, i.e. from a wound. Okay, so kind of like clotting it. Thank you. I guess so. You can take cinnamon, I guess like the sticks or pieces of it, and if you're bleeding, to put it on. That's good if somebody's on like a blood thinner or something like that. That's good to know. Yeah, but that was colt's foot. Thank you, Lil Babber, for looking that up. I've never heard that before. I wonder if it's has bad properties to drink like a lot of cinnamon or a lot of things with cinnamon or eat a lot of things with cinnamon. If it's like can make your blood too thick. You like greeny things do, like spinach.
Man, 2012, see, plantain. That was crazy. The people that did the cinnamon challenge.
So, this is plantain. I wonder if this is the same plantain like my husband eats. Okay, so here in the mountains, we have plantain. And, oh, wait, no, I'm thinking, what's the one that's poisonous? Go ask guys what the one is that's poisonous.
What is it?
So there's this plant that's poisonous. I'm asking, I'm having Abbie ask guys what it is right now, but.
I don't know what I'm supposed to ask.
Yeah, plantain's the, it's like, it looks like spinach, and it grows wild all in the yard and everywhere. It's really good. And what you do is you pull it, you kill, what is it, kilt it with, kill it with, like grease, like bacon grease. You'll put it in the pan, you'll kind of put the grease over top of it. What's the one that's poisonous? The plant that Mama would fry you eggs with. That's poisonous.
Polk.
Polk? It's polk. Okay, so the other one, that's polk. The other one's is polk, and it's the one with, like, the berries on it. I don't know if it's all over the West Coast and everywhere polk else, weed. Too, but, yeah, polk weed. It has, like, the little, once it goes to berry, it has, like, the berries that stain, but that's highly poisonous, like, can kill you. But if you get it when it's first growing, then you can kill it, too. It's called killing it or kilt?
No, it's...
with the grease.
You boil it. Double boil it.
You double boil it to get the toxins out of it?
Yeah, if there's any.
I know it's highly dangerous to even try to eat it, but Mamaw would make it for Oz and fry it with eggs. Yeah.
Like a half inch or an inch and a half to 2 inches.
Mm.
Like very small.
You would still use it as paint, though, like the ink on it. Yeah.
So this is this. So this is dried plantain. Yeah, so plantain grows in the yard. It looks like it's already gone to seed. We have something else, too, we eat here, and we probably need to go look up in the mountain tomorrow and see if it hasn't gone to seed yet. But everybody has, like, their secret spots for different things, like morel mushrooms, or and you don't tell anybody about it, but the you know, things you can't buy in the store, and morel mushrooms, you got ramps, which, does anyone in chat know what a ramp is? So good. Yeah, it's a wild leek, so it tastes like a peppery garlic onion. And it's so good. And they don't, like, sell them in the stores or anything, but they have festivals for them. And the other thing is branch lettuce that we need to go check out tomorrow. Make sure it hasn't gone to seed and get some. But branch lettuce, so a branch, so you have your creek, you have rivers, then you have your creeks. And then as in the mountain where it comes down, like, smaller flowing water is called branches. So in that, this lettuce stuff grows. And there's different variations. There's, like, fuzzy ones. There's purple. There's green. And it's so good. It's really good for you. It's called branch lettuce. So plantain.
We have ramps today.
You have ramps today?
If they want to see one, it's in the potatoes.
Is that a big piece?
I can get one.
So plantain, and most people, I'm guessing this probably grows everywhere in the United States, but it's just that stuff that looks like spinach in your yard, and then eventually it turns to these little flowers. Some of them will be purple, some are white. Says plantains used for spells and rituals, for personal strength, for protection, healing, and to give you energy and courage. I definitely need some of that. Add to charm bags for protection, or hang over your door to ensure only pleasant people enter, or hang in your car to guard against the intrusion of evil spirits. Add to healing sachets and charm bags, then place underneath the bed to keep illness away. It's really neat. And if anybody wants me to make them up anything like this and mail it to you, if you're willing to give your address to me, I'm willing to do that. Oh, cool. Let me see another one. So Oz at work, they had like a thing today for Easter, and they had, these are ramps. So these are the bulbs of ramps. That's like the bottom. And they don't get any bigger than this. So it looks like an onion, like how onion grows. But that's the bulbs of it. And you can use the entire plant. And then, oh, at the top of it, it has these like leaves like this, like two green leaves. Look at it. Yeah, we need to go out and see tomorrow if we can find any branch lettuce. Maybe we'll get lucky and find some morels.
Chicken of the woods is what I want.
Yes, chicken of the woods is so good. If we ever get some, hi Sly, if we ever get some chicken of the woods, I have to show you. Now my hand smells like garlic. Ooh, it smells strong. Okay, let's see, Rue. Here, it must be on the back. No, where's Rue at? Do you see Rue up here, Pumpkin?
Hmm?
Do you see Rue? Oh, here it is. So Rue, it says Rue, and it's just a bunch of, it's like a bunch of dry grass clippings. And, ooh, it does smell good. I think they all just smell good because they've been bagged up together. It says Rue, I got your joke, baby. Is it RuPaul? It says it's a sacred herb for protection. It's used in to counteract, to exercise negative feelings.
What company?
Called the Herb of Grace because it can be carried into either emotional or physical battle. The planet is Mars and the element's fire. That's neat. That's kind of weird that the planet is Mars but the element's fire. Usually Mars is with water. I'll put the company in my description, Sly. I got that. Let's see. How many candles? 20? 20 candles, I think. 20 candles, different colors. The herbs. Some more. Let's see. What else is it? Oh, some other bottles of crystals for $30.
I'll show the crystal box.
We're going to do the crystals next. We're going to do the crystals in another. That's the crystals.
We'll do that in another live.
How many is that, Pungan? 12? It's okay, 12 bottles of crystals.
4, 5, 6. 6 times 2 is 12, yeah.
And you can't pick exactly which herbs you want or which crystals you want, but you can pick...
like a mystery box.
How many herbs you know, you could pick a variation of, I want, you know, 20 different herbs and the 12 different crystals and 10 candles.
It's like a snack pack. It's like,
yeah, it's kind of like a mystery, but you got to kind of pick. But I'll put it in the description. Okay, rose petals. Oh, yeah, I needed more resources. There's quite a few plants I want to try to grow on my own. I want to get it's a root. What's the root, Sly, I told you I wanted to get? That I've been looking into, like, the buyer to get. Ugh, it's poisonous.
Why looking for poisonous stuff?
Because that's a long story, but okay, it's
understandable.
Okay. Then we got rose petals. These look like red rose petals, dried. They're good for spells involving love, lust, innocent, confidence, trust, divination, healing, truth, romance, sexuality, and luck and protection. Do you want to go ahead and do some of your... do you want me to keep doing these herbs, or should we let Abbie do a round of her guess the song?
Hey, guess the song! what? I don't know.
Yeah, I can't remember what it was either, Sly, when we were talking about it the other night.
My cat is up here chilling.
Do you like the smell of that? My cat's smelling the box. What is all this stuff? Now the dog's interested in it.
Crystal pets. That sounds like it'd be a show.
I guess I'll breeze through these so then she can have all the attention. Hyssops.
I'm an attention seeker.
See what hyssops are for. I can find them.
2022, quote Abbie. Hyssops. I'm an attention seeker.
So hyssops remove negativity and for purification, good for cleansing your auras, consecrating sacred tools. You use amethyst and lapis lazuli. That's lapis lazuli. That's that lapis lazuli.
Lapis lazuli. How do you say it?
Sorry, if you don't have a lapis lazuli.
Lazuli. People.
Lazuli. I think it's lazuli. That's how I always heard it. You need to get one. That's a hyssop.
I like your tiny plants.
My tiny plants, I know. They're clippings.
Tiny things are...
my window is full of clippings right now. I need to get them in the ground and outside.
Am I the only one that collects the objects? They're so adorable.
I'm sure you're not the only one that collects tiny things. I know, you love tiny things.
And bottle caps.
So this is nettle. And it says it's used as a protection... And return curses. So if someone curses you, you can return the curse with it. It's a good herb for consecration and good for restoring balance. So that's really neat that this is this hyssop, that it's good for consecrating sacred tools. So I could use that with some of my tools that I have. And also for cleansing auras, I guess you would use it kind of like you do smudging. Like I would have it in the shell and burn it, like smudge myself with it. My cat now, after smelling the box of herbs, is acting psycho. So Basil.
No, he's playing with the snake.
Basil.
He's playing with the snake.
The dried snake. Pick it up.
I don't want to pick it up.
Get it. Don't let him have the snake.
I don't want to pick it up.
Oh my goodness. Is basil works as protective herb or magical herb for money? So if some of you are interested,
I'm sorry, you threw it on the foot.
If some of you are interested in, say, learning how to work with some of these herbs and things like that, you don't have to necessarily do spells. You can just be like a kitchen type witch, and you can just you can more work with your food. You know, adding different things to your food and the way you prepare it and the way you stir things, you know, versus if you're adding something to it, like love, whatever, if you want it to take, you know, something away, the counter stirring. There. So if anybody wants to look into something like that, it would be called a kitchen witch, and look up into how you can do kind of ritualistic work through food. It's cloves. Oh, you can definitely smell these through the thing. Cloves always remind me of teeth, like about your teeth. And I used to smoke cloves. Oh, anybody yeah, else in chat ever smoke cloves?
Can I explain?
What?
Back in the old times, they used to like brush their teeth with clove.
They would brush their teeth with
like what is it? Like the toothbrush.
Hold on, hold on, search the H. Shoot. We have some of it's Oz. Go ask Oz what a favorite scent is. What is that stuff called? There's different things that they would brush their teeth with, but that's one of them.
Whorehound.
Yeah, whorehound. Whorehound.
Whorehound.
Oh my gosh, I love the smell of whorehound. Oh, love it. It's my husband's like favorite smell. That moss. So cloves is good for a magic love spell using clove, a hot spice that helps protect, banish negativity, and boost confidence. It just makes me nauseous smelling it. Makes me nauseous. Lady's mantle. Lots of sticky, like just sticks. Oh, it looks like it's got some kind of, not really sure. It's like they took the stems and dried them and pulled them apart. It's got the meat of the stem inside of it. Lady's mantle. Let's see. It's a feminine herb that's ruled by Venus, making it good for use in any love magic spells and sachets. I'm just very, yes, you see, Sly, you're probably, you consider yourself, I don't really consider myself a witch, but as far as the different types of witches there are, you probably have a wide range of the ones that, you know, what you could be categorized as, just like I can. Especially in wintertime, I think all witches become like a kitchen witch in the wintertime. Lady's mantle. I'm kind of torn about doing any kind of love spell. I'll do like attraction spell or self-love. But when it comes to like trying to force someone to fall in love with someone else, that I have a hard time with. Like I'm not okay with doing that for anyone. Bay leaves. I know one thing with bay leaves is luck. If you want to win a court case, fill that plate with full of bay leaves. Eat as much bay leaves as you can. Get the oil for it. Sleep with them under your pillow. So bay leaves are for wealth, prosperity, or your job and employment. Like if you're wanting a raise or something, bay leaves are great for that. Abundance. And let's see it. And then there's an actual spell. It's just called a bay leaf witch spell. I have lots of bags of bay leaves. It's one thing you always got to keep is bay leaves in your house. Peppermint. Which we have lots of peppermint growing around here. It seems like when you plant one plant of peppermint, it will spread through the entire yard within 2 years.
Yeah,
so. And you can open it up. You got to open it up because they all smell the same. Mm-hmm. So it says peppermint, the most common used as altar supplies for magical rites and spells. It's also used as a magical herb for money. You can create Wiccan money spells, ward off evil spirits. Yes, you could. Oh, I don't know if I'd trust that one to eat it. Eat from a... Oh my gosh, it smells so good.
It smells like one you use for...
And sometimes you can use it for love spells. Do you think like the sweeter scents are the ones that you're going to use for more love-oriented, more positive type spells. Whereas the more spicier, I mean, just spicy, like even cinnamon type spicy, you'd use.
How do I pronounce his name?
Mr. F. U. In terms of how to pronounce his name. Hey, you. How you doing? I'm going over herbs and what they're good for as far as spell work. And then if you stick around, we're almost done with this. And then my daughter's going to, we're going to play Guess That Game, Guess That Song. She's going to play the music on the keyboard. And we're going to play for a prize. Okay, so we got sage. So I know one thing for sages, for purification.
We've got five people watching. Hello, everybody.
So sage is, it's a sacred herb. It's kind of like frankincense, and it's a sacred herb. And it's used in purification and healing and cleansing. It carries the virtues of strength and mental health. Should be grown alongside rue to keep the energies pure. Oh, that's neat to know. So if anybody wants to grow sage, they suggest growing rue beside sage. And that strengthens the sage. It's really weird. It's mostly sticks in it, though. I prefer a dragon's blood sage. So it's just sage that's been dipped in dragon's blood, which my stick is almost out of. But that and Palo Santos. Yeah.
What is that one?
This is goldenrod. So I know goldenrod, as far as physical, goldenrod is good for allergies.
Is it rose petals?
See, goldenrod.
Is it rose petals?
Yeah, they're in there.
Ooh.
Did you miss that?
No, I was not paying attention. You didn't know this.
Goldenrod is used in rituals concerning money matters. Wearing goldenrod enables you to see your future lover, and it helps healing. So I guess for something like that, you need something like this. This is like, I can put my herbs in it or my oils. Or you could probably carry it in just a little sachet. It helps you to see your future love. We got mugwort. Probably little rocks or something in it. It's kind of sparkly. Okay, mugwort. So there's mother's wort and then there's mugwort. Mugwort's used for strength, healing, visionary dreams. It's a good herb for consecrating tools and crystals. So we definitely be using that. Hey, Yasmina. I didn't see Yasmina come in. I'll need to do the dragon sage. I may add one or two others. One's more toxic. The mugwort. And they give you quite a bit when you order it too, Sly. They could give you quite a bit in this with this company to start off. And you can see which ones you like, which ones you prefer, you know. So, marjoram. It's really powdery, really fine, grated down. Marjoram is placed in charm bags to ease depression and lift the spirit. Good for general healing, money, happiness spells. Its planet is Mercury, and its element's air. So I'm going to have to learn all the other ones. I think it only lists maybe three or four in the little booklet. See, it came with this too, Sly, and with the crystals, it came with a thing as well. So it came with a little...
So it's a Sagittarius? Wait, no, I'm wrong.
It's air.
It's air.
So it'd have three signs for it if it was air, pumpkin. Which ones it would probably work with.
I don't know.
Okay, down to our last one, and you can try your...
Oh, we know Virgo and Sagittarius.
Then we can play the game.
Woo! Get it!
So we got... My dread is stuck. In my sleeve. All right, we got violet is the last but not least. This one's really neat. It's got actual whole flowers.
I know, that's
dried.
The one I like.
And right now is the time to go out and get violets and dry them. Mm-hmm. So let's see what violets are good for. Violets promote modesty. I'm about to put them all over Abby's room. She's pretty modest. So violets promote modesty. They promote sympathy and serenity. They encourage peace, inspiration, and good fortune. So that's what violets are good for. These are some pretty big violets. Okay.
Give me a second. Are you sure with the camera?
Yeah, I'm going to flip the camera over to you. Just for a second to show you. Go ahead.
For a second to show me. No. We keep the camera right here. I have a whole setup, sweetheart.
Whoever wants to play the game. With Strawberry Abbie. She's going to play songs on her keyboard, and then the first to guess the song in chat
gets a point.
Gets a point. And whoever gets the most points wins.
We have 14 games if we can make it. Because it's not really long songs. Do you got a pen? I got everything I need. I need a pen. Hold on, can I test the audio real quick?
Yes,
go ahead. I need my own camera over here. Because I'm getting a face.
Play a couple notes so I see if you can hear. Can y'all hear that okay?
I can turn up the volume.
I think it's good. It's picking up good.
I'm just testing. How fast?
Yeah, it is dry. It is driving the cat crazy. A little bit. Whipping. Wynn got. I have a dried snake, like a baby snake that we had found up on the wall.
I'm scared of it.
It's like a shelf with just like some different bones and skulls, things like that. And it got up on the wall. Never has messed with a snake. Got up there and got it down. Was playing with it. And he's an older baby. He's like 8.
Here comes the older baby.
Okay, little bad whiff. That sounds good. Slice it. Sounds good. Okay. She wants me to show her real quick. Let me put the camera around.
Hello.
She's our little. Let me unplug this for a second. She's got a little crystal set up on her.
Listen.
Her peep.
Peep season, man.
Her East. And that's is probably the only time y'all will ever see her in a dress. She does not wear dresses.
I feel feminine today, okay? I
barely
feel feminine.
Little Bad Wolf says, you're adorable.
Thank you. I know I am.
Okay. And then Little Bad Wolf said, introducing Abbie on the keyboard. Okay.
Okay, and I'm just testing it and playing something. I'm like, go through stuff to make me feel comfortable. Okay, feel comfortable.
Okay, so song number one, here we go. Let's see who gets it first.
That one, I made a mess up.
Does anybody know what that is? That's an older song. She likes older music.
I can play again.
Yeah, play it again.
Go okay, because I okay. And that's all I'm playing.
Any guesses? This song's from probably what, like the 50s?
Yeah, maybe.
I'll give a clue. It has the word fire in the title. Doesn't it?
Yeah, the last word. If you can't get it, I can go into the next song. Yes! Somebody got it?
Yes. Who got it? I have pen paper. Who got it? It's not showing up on mine. Oh, Sly got it. Wait. No. Sly got it?
Yes.
Oh, set the one on fire. Yasmina got it. Good job, Yasmina.
Yasmina.
Yasmina's younger, too, aren't you? Yasmina. Got 1 point.
Okay. So the next song's going to be...
Good job, Yasmina.
I dropped my phone. I'm sorry. I'm looking at chat. Give me a second.
I don't know. That's what she likes, Little Bad Wolf. It's like really old songs.
Okay, the next one's like a newer Disney song, so. I could continue playing.
It takes a second for the StreamYard, like, lag behind. Do you know what that one is? It's a newer song to Disney. Play it again.
Okay. Oh, God, I forgot the notes for a second. You want to play more?
I think your chat's showing before my chat. My chat's behind.
Do you want to play more?
Did anybody guess it yet?
No, but I will play the rest.
Go ahead, if you want to play the rest of
okay.
it. Okay. Wait to see if anybody catches what it is. From a Disney movie. I love this movie, by the way. It's a really good movie.
trouble for you playing the whole song?
No, don't worry.
Well, yeah, I'm looking for something. I'm going to do. Okay.
It's from Disney. Hopefully it is.
Maybe somebody will figure it out later.
Okay, well.
Yes, maybe you don't know that one too? If y'all have not seen that movie, y'all need to see it.
Okay, do you want to go now?
Yeah, go ahead and see what it is.
We don't talk about Bruno. I almost dropped my phone again.
It's the Bruno song that we don't talk about Bruno. It's from Encantino.
Encanto.
I love that movie. So have you seen that? They're Brazil, right?
No, Colombian.
Colombian.
Okay.
It's such a good movie. It's about family magic. I'm too old.
Here's another Disney one. But
it's a really good movie, though.
Older Disney.
Well, play what is that? Oh, let's see what you got going on. What's your next song after?
The one word. One word Disney movie.
Here, play number six.
Number six?
Yeah, this is another old one. I was crying listening to this earlier. Hey, Sassy Nerd Girl. You love that movie? Have you seen it? It's so good.
Okay, ready?
Encanto. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is an old song, and she was playing it earlier and singing to it. I was crying. Okay, go ahead. You keep playing it? You know the rest of it?
Yeah, I know the rest.
Keep playing. I just want you to keep playing. I love hearing her play this song. Yep. The bad wolf got it.
Are you going to do the rest?
I told her, it's times like that that, like, I wish her dad was here physically so we could see him.
Okay, don't cry!
I know, I'm trying not to. Little Bad Wolf beat you, Yasmina. Yep.
Okay, I'm going to play number four.
Oh, it's like put it in Spanish.
Ready?
Okay, go ahead.
I got it.
Next song, is this a newer song or older song?
It's an older one.
Well, older based on what? Like, older? Oh, this is like our age, y'all. So this would be like a song for us in our, like, 20s. Because I'm 43. So it would be like a song in my 20s. Yeah, so this song's about 20 years
old. She's 27!
Okay, go ahead. You're playing kind of fast.
Okay, let me retry that. I'm nervous.
Try it again.
Whatever, that's all you're giving, because it's going to go on forever. But I can do one other part from it.
Go ahead.
No. Wait. Hey.
This is what it's like in here all day long, like every weekend.
Listen, I'm going from memory. That's a good thing.
Here very, very soon, it's going to be all the time. We have to get her a piano. We had a piano before. When you have to get them tuned.
I'm just gonna say the band is from a vegetable, I think.
A vegetable? They don't know fruit.
This person fruit? No, it's not.
I mean a fruit. Sorry,
vegetable.
I don't know. I think those things can be considered fruit too.
Yeah.
Like tomatoes are.
They can be whatever they want to be. It's 2022, Mom.
Did y'all hear that? We're turned to the side. Did anybody guess that what that was? Because they were. She was saying the name of the band is a vegetable. And I was like, no, it's a fruit, I think. She said it's 2022. They can be whatever they want.
They can identify as an attack helicopter if they wanted to.
They can go to school and say they're cats and demand a litter box.
Okay, ready?
Anybody guess what that was?
If they didn't... Okay.
Was the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Don't stop.
Yeah, don't stop.
Okay, I'm gonna do
stop the spirits when they move you.
Yeah. Okay, here's a really old one, but it's so iconic, anybody will know it. But do you know the name?
Mm-hmm.
almost messed up.
I don't know what the name of that one is.
Just say the creator. Just say the creator.
Play the Red Hot Chili Pepper one again. Okay. You, now you notice what it was, Sassy Nerd Girl.
Yeah, somebody got it. Sassy Nerd Girl.
Yeah. This play it again.
Okay. Hold on. I got to get the tapping fast enough.
Play the other part of it.
Okay.
She's looking at me as she's playing it. Sly said Mozart or Unchained Melody.
No,
Yasmina
no.
said Unchained Melody.
A Sassy Girl got it right.
Or Sassy no, I mean the last one you were just playing.
Yeah.
The
Sassy Girl got it right.
Oh, she did she? Yeah, that was the Red Hot Chili Pepper ones. I don't even know the name of it. So it's Fur Eloise. Yeah, Little Bad Wolf and Sassy Nerd Girl got it both.
Okay.
But Sassy got it first.
I'm about to play some.
Sassy, how do you know what that is?
It's music. It's real music.
Do you play music, Sassy Nerd Girl? Does anybody else in chat play music?
I play saxophone, piano.
But it's by Beethoven?
Yeah.
Oz's favorite song is Midnight Sonata.
Sonata?
Yeah. You need to learn how to play that.
I'm trying
to. My gosh,
to.
This song's so pretty. I found a YouTube video with this elderly man playing it. And then this elderly woman in a nursing home came back playing it, like, with him or whatever, kind of like duetted him, but it's a YouTube type thing, so it was
I've
so
I've got
neat.
One. Okay, so here's one, it's really iconic, and it's one of my favorite ones to play. That's all I'm playing. Y'all got it?
Anybody get it?
No.
Play it again.
Oh, okay. I'm very proud.
Such a wide range of songs.
Like, my music playlist on YouTube is like...
a little piano.
Such like chill piano, that you get music. To...
Sassy Nerd Girl likes classical music. Listen to the Silver Swan. Have you heard the Silver Swan yet?
Nah.
I'll have to have her listen to that after this. I heard it, but can't think of the name and artist. Did everybody give up?
No.
Play just the chorus part of it that you were just playing. So the beginning, just the chorus.
Probably
even both ends? Sure. Everybody's like stumped.
It starts with an H!
Yeah, it starts with an H. It's a place.
No, is it? Or is it a girl's name?
It's a place, isn't it? And not a place?
Yes! Somebody got it!
Who got it?
I forgot. So this starts with a Y. Yasmina?
Yasmina.
Yasmina!
Yasmina, are we saying your name right?
I'm sorry.
Havana,
I'm...
yes. Isn't Havana a place? It's a place.
Havana, ooh, nah, nah.
Yeah.
It's a girl's name. It can be...
I'm sure it could be a girl's name, too.
Okay, now I'm sure...
Yasmina's a two.
Next one I picked on the last minute.
Yasmina's winning.
Y'all just got rickrolled.
You gotta sing that. He just rickrolled the. He just rickrolled everybody. I love you, kid.
Anyway,
we all just got rickrolled.
Anyway, okay, here's an actual one.
Okay, go ahead. So here's a song. Sing it in your head as you're doing it, so you got it. You gotta start over because I was talking.
Oh yeah.
Sorry. Okay, go ahead.
Meyer. Going off memory. Whatever, I messed up. Don't listen to the last part, but you know. You got the beginning, right?
That's what I was going to say. Hi, hi. I got my, we're playing yes, Guess That Song.
Yasmina. Got it again.
Okay, my daughter's playing the keyboard. Little Bath Wolf said Ice Ice Baby.
I know that is, isn't it?
Yeah, it is Ice Ice Baby as well.
Yasmina's got it. It's Under Pressure. Okay. Right again.
I messed up.
Touching down on me.
I'm a big Queen fan, okay?
She loves Queen. Okay, what's your next one?
Okay.
Yasmina's winning in with 3. Little Bad Wolf's got 1, and Sassy's got 1.
Okay. I'm trying to remember. Okay, never. Don't listen to that. That was just me trying to remember how to play a note.
She was remembering the keys. Sly said Ice Ice Baby, too.
Okay. Okay. Gosh darn it, I'm failing! That's all I'm playing.
That's a video game.
It's a game.
I can't believe you're playing I Don't Want to Set the World on Fire.
It's such a good song.
What is this song? Is this from a movie? I mean, a show?
Where?
That song.
That's from...
Oh,
yeah, I was going to play that one, mother!
Go ahead, try that one. Okay, so this one's from... So the other one was Mario. And then this one's from... Did anybody get that?
No.
Okay, it's the Mario song.
Let me play this one. Okay.
This is from a Disney movie.
It's an old one. It's a sad Disney
movie.
It's
not an old Disney movie, but it's older. It's probably about 15 years old, something like that.
Yeah. Wait, no!
Anybody guess what that was?
I don't think people listen to background music, but it's really good.
Oh, it's just a background. It's not like a main
song. No, but it's like a main song to a song.
These are the songs you got?
I could do more. But those are the ones I got.
All of them. You played all of them.
No, I didn't. I got memories. Okay.
Oh, here, play this one, number 7.
Number 7?
Hold on, let's see if anybody got it.
Oh, that's the one.
Anybody get that one? No. Yeah. Sassy Nergal says no.
It's Married Life from Up.
Yeah,
where she dies! Oh, I'm sorry! Trigger warning!
You're yelling in everybody's ear.
I'm sorry!
It was from the movie Up. Yo, so it's in the beginning when she passes away.
Yeah.
His wife passes
away. But, like, they're building and then they passed away. And
it's from the movie Up with the house with all the balloons.
Okay.
Thing number 7. Okay.
So this is
everybody should get this one.
Ready?
Hi, Moth Duck.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
You don't know how to play the rest of it? We'll play that part again.
I just learned it today! I think I can do it like... Wait.
No, you butchered it. Yep, the Little Bad Wolf got it, even with just that little bit.
Yes!
She sits with her phone with, like, the keys, like, YouTube videos with the keys playing, and she just memorizes stuff. She can read music, too, from her saxophone. She learned how to read music playing her saxophone. So, let's see. Little Bad Wolf got... Okay, so Little Bad Wolf's got 2, Sassy's got 1, and Yasmina's got 3. You got any more songs?
Yes, I got some.
Yeah, that was it, Little Bad Wolf. It was Billie Jean.
I got some more songs.
It was
Michael
Jackson's Billie Jean.
I got more songs. Huh? I can go on my phone real quick.
Okay, go ahead. Find some other songs.
Okay, I won't be able to read chat real quick.
But make sure you mute it so it doesn't make it echo.
So this might sound worse because I'm reading while I'm doing it. But
you're gonna mute it? Okay, go
ahead. It's muted.
Okay. Let's see. Hi, you saw that? My favorite bean. Was on the live, so I thought I would stop by real quick.
I got one.
Yeah, we're doing it. She was begging me to come on and do a contest, everyone. We did that drawing contest before. So she wanted to do another contest to give away one of her paintings.
I got it. I forgot there's one. Wait. You know this one very well.
Does anybody know what that one was? She was almost named after this song.
Oh, please, no.
Cup Fendi says, I do. You can't play.
No.
Neither can Moth Duck.
Yeah, back off.
Like, Sassy got it.
Yay.
Sassy and Little Bad Wolf are tied for
you
two.
I learned...
Yeah, her dad almost named her Delilah.
What?
Last minute named her Abigail. And she's born the first day of autumn. She probably should have been named Autumn. Well, all my children have A name. Their names start with A's. They're my four aces. But she's Abigail.
And that's why you ain't having a fifth child.
She needed a southern name.
Abigail. Okay. So
you can play Cub Fendi.
Okay, I got this
and,
one.
And Moth Duck. Y'all can play if you want. I'm just kidding.
I learned this one today. Moth Duck, you might know this one from TikTok. Ready? Mom, we were listening to this one today. Ready?
Go ahead.
Wait. Give me some.
I know how it goes, but I don't know the name of that.
Okay. Ah, I can't do
breathe,
it.
Or even just take a second.
Okay.
Don't get frustrated with
this
yourself.
This try, I will get it.
Is it little? Is it the plain white tees that sing Delilah?
I don't know.
Do you even know what that one was? I know it, I just can't think. I know how the song goes. Yeah, it is the one at the diner.
Yeah, whoever got that?
Malta got it.
I know.
Is that what it's called, the diner?
Yeah.
It's called the diner. It's like da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So Malta, you got one. So we're playing for either a painting of your choice. Abby, Strawberry Abbie will paint something for you, or if you don't want to give your address, then we're going to do a Amazon gift card like we did the last one.
Okay, so I have an idea. I'm going to play a song, and I'm going to keep on playing the whole thing until somebody gets it. That way I don't mess up over it. I can actually
watch it. I don't know. That's a good idea.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
It's fine. She says it's fine.
Okay, and I feel more comfortable. Ready?
He says, I like that. I know. It's like this all weekend long when she's here. I love it. Oh, is it? Okay.
I knew it.
Is it called The Magic of Life? Is that what it's called by him? Okay. This is a newer song. Well, it's probably years old. She can play that, can't she?
What?
That's right here. It is really, really common. Today we had the windows open and just had her playing. It was just so peaceful.
Okay, I'm stopping for a second.
Does anybody know what that is?
If nobody knows...
He was at the... You can't... You go. You can't guess.
No.
You can't guess.
I don't have to guess.
You guess.
He was at the. They were at the Super Bowl. He was at the Super Bowl not too long ago.
And he has weird face surgery, but we don't judge because it's 2022.
You called it weird.
Okay. Shh.
Unique. You say unique.
Unique. Same.
Did anybody guess it? Oh, you don't have it pulled up.
Let me see it.
Did anybody guess it? Guess who that was?
If you can guess the music artist or.
Okay, play it again. Play the chorus part.
Wait.
Da 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 da. Is anybody? Anybody?
I'll say the first word. Save your. That's it.
That is the weekend.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going. I'm finding something.
Yeah, look, they all, okay, now it pops up. Yeah, the weekend. Little Bad Wolf got it before Sassy Nerd Girl. Okay. Save your tears for another day by the weekend.
Here's one.
She can play most of his songs. She loves the weekend.
Sassy Nerd Girl got it.
Little Bad Wolf's up here on my thing, the weekend. And Sassy Nerd Girl got it by the name.
Okay, so next song's coming
I'm going to give it to Sassy and Little Bad Wolf. Okay. Oh, look, so Yasmina, Little Bad Wolf, and Sassy are all tied.
Woo!
And then we got Moth Duck with one.
Okay, here we go. Okay, give me a second. I messed up already. We're fine.
Mr. Effie, it's my 14-year-old. My little pumpkin. I have no idea what you're playing.
You know this one.
No, I don't. Anybody got an idea? I don't know what it is.
Now.
Mr. Effie says that's awesome.
Okay.
Play play the chorus because I have no clue what you're playing. She's doing a great job. Thank you. She is good.
Nobody knows
it. I have no idea what it was. What was it?
It's Burning Pile! All my troubles in a burning pile.
Oh, okay.
I guess I'm going to get something that most people know. I'm going to get some... Working on it.
Play some more, MJ.
Okay. Working on it. I don't listen
to... Did you teach her? Oh, no. I didn't teach her. She taught herself. Like, honestly.
The person
she's been playing music since... Moth Duck. How long has she been playing music? Since she came out the womb. Like... She's always been able to keep a beat, you know, but and been interested in instruments. But she grew up around instruments. Like, there's so many in our family and all around us that play instruments.
Me.
Her dad could play, like, every instrument. Anything he picked up, he could play. And her her bonus dad, he's a DJ, or a retired DJ. So she's always been around music.
Got the next song.
My nephew, who she's really close with, her favorite cousin, he has a band.
Oh.
So she picks up stuff by her ear.
I'm in the band.
You got a request.
What is it?
Mr. Effie says, can you play Baby by Justin Bieber?
Yes, I can, actually.
She said she can. She's going to play it for you.
Yes, I can.
Yeah, I was drawing a blank too, Cessna Girl. It was that, the Burning Pile song.
You know, where everybody was using. On a burning pile, I'll lit up and I start to smile. If
it's a good song.
Catch a file and change with it. Okay.
You know, the people on TikTok that had the lighters, they were doing that lighter thing.
Okay, give me a second. YouTube's being.
I think that's how that song became famous, was TikTok.
No, I listened to it because of weirdcore music. Weirdcore.
Yeah, she's into weirdcore music. All right, she's looking it up, Mr. F. You, the keys to the.
I'm a play it. It's the first time I've ever played it. I'm sorry. I'm high energy.
Her ADHD is, like, through the charts right now. She's so excited. But she's always been interested in music. And then her dad got her... So she's always had different instruments. But her dad got her a saxophone. Like, a really expensive, nice saxophone. So she got in the band. And that was before the pandemic. But once the pandemic hit, then they didn't have band anymore. And but she's learned how to read music and just kept up with it, and like she's touched her saxophone and probably a year and a half, 2 years.
I still probably play it. I remember the notes. They burned it in my memory.
I kind of like that she's not playing the saxophone. I'd much rather you have to play the keyboard. But
we're working on it.
In the house right now, we have several guitars, the keyboard, the banjo, violin. Quite a few instruments in the house.
I want a tomatone.
Automaton.
The weird faith instrument? Okay, mm-hmm. This is the first time I'm learning the song, so
woo! Oh, she just got access to a steel drum, and that's really pretty.
Okay, here we go!
Her cousin got a steel drum, and we got to borrow it for a bit. That was fun. Here's your song.
Okay, it's going to be kind of messed up, okay? Because look at the beginning.
She's learning this right now as she's playing it. But here's Justin Bieber, Baby.
I know how to do the beginning, if I can pause it real quick.
Look at all the chords and stuff on the end. Let's try the basics first. Okay.
Okay, this is like the first note. Okay, yeah, I know it. As I mess up, give me a second. It's going to take a second.
Just breathe and do it.
Not going to sound right, but it's going to sound like it. Gosh darn it, calm down. Okay,
you gotta work on your timing with it.
I will learn this next live.
Okay, so Mr. FU, she's gonna learn it, and then next live, she will play it for you. She's gonna work on it.
I promise. But let's do some MJ.
Okay, she's gonna play an MJ song, and we gotta guess what it is.
I love
Mr. FU. Now she's going to be practicing. So thank you, Mr. FU, because now I'm going to have to hear Justin Bieber for the rest of this weekend.
No. I have a good song.
What is it? You know how to play it?
Yes, I know this one by heart.
Okay. Take a breath.
You should see my feet right now. They're running.
I know.
I'm Sonic.
Sassy, are you still in here? She said, she got all excited. She said, you should see my feet right now. I'm running. I'm Sonic.
Okay, ready? Hold on. I have to move octaves. I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I love you, Mother. I have to turn up my brightness. I can't see. I'm blind. Okay.
She done lost all the coins. Sings it. I know the song. Play Delaware. Mothuk's got a request for you. Okay, Mothuk, I got you next. If I can get her to stop. Is anybody gonna guess what this is?
Elo.
Oh, it's Mr. Blue Sky. Moonlight Sonata. That's my husband's favorite song. She's okay. Gonna have to learn how to play
request
that.
Request for me.
Well, I can't name it. It's in the left my. It's in the left my brain.
Okay, what is it?
that was that Mr. Blue Sky. She said by Elo. I thought it was a Beatles.
Real quick, while y'all are thinking, can I put my energy?
She said play Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton.
Planet Dolly Parton is what she said.
Okay, I got you.
Do you know one?
I got you.
Okay.
Okay. I forgot. See, I have to know the lyrics to a song before I play it, so I know the beat.
Does anyone in chat know if anybody else is live? Like, I don't want to intrude on anybody's lives. And if you gotta, if you need to go, Little Bad Wolf, like, no worries, because I'm sitting in front of the laptop. It didn't look like there's gonna be any trouble in chat.
Okay, we're working on it. We have a Jake from State Farm ad renew.
Jake from State Farm ad.
Okay.
All right, here's your Dolly Parton song, Moth Duck.
Okay, I don't have the actual notes. Oh my lord, calm down, Dolly.
Calm down, Dolly.
I had to find it, please.
Dolly will never calm down.
Please bless me for a second.
You gotta channel Dolly.
Whew!
Channel the Dolly. Nope, okay, good. How did I not know that? I woke him up with the Guardians. Oh, so that's what it's from. It's from the Guardians of the Galaxy. Okay. She can play most of those songs on the Guardians of the Galaxy album, can't she?
Okay, I got it.
Yasmin's already got it.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay.
Yeah, yes, we got it.
I gotta learn these.
Is that
songs.
9 to 5?
Yeah, I wanna learn that now.
9 to 5. Now she's gonna have to learn that song, Yasmina.
Thank y'all for making me have to find more catchy music to learn. Okay.
So pick one or two more songs and we'll be done.
Can I show how talented I am real quick?
Because you've been on, let's see, can for I an hour and 13 minutes.
Nobody's gonna know what this is. I told you it's.
You can play that for your very last song after you play two songs that people can guess.
Okay.
Let me come look at your. Let me get up. Come look at your.
My yes. Recommended.
Yes.
Let's see.
If I my phone's being poofy.
That's one that you've played a lot. You practiced a lot.
Nobody's gonna know it, but Kelsey.
Moth Duck.
I kept
doing that the other night too.
Okay.
We'll play one that others will know.
Nobody's gonna know what that is.
Rhapsody, play Rhapsody.
You're right, I can't! No. Okay. I love this one,
Okay. This is an older song. This is before my time.
Oh no, cable! It's broken! Okay, we got it! I know this one by heart.
Year-old got her music taste. Place in a special quest for any song by Andy Gibb for next time. Okay.
Okay.
I'll write it down. Little Bad Wolf. And I'll also send you updates as she's practicing it this weekend.
Okay.
Andy Gibb. What about the one that was right underneath that you played a lot? This one. Let me see. It was that one.
That's not the one. I never
played. Have you played that one?
No, never.
Have you played any of their songs?
I played this one, but I think we've already
You already did that one. You already played that one. Oh, that one.
I don't know that one really well.
Yes, you do.
No, not much. And
I love the song. And you can play it good.
Okay, someone can play it good.
And even though she knew this on the piano. Yeah.
Kelsey? I mean,
that's because she's an old soul. I know. She really is.
Okay.
She's definitely one of a kind.
There we go.
I'm amazed she came for me because. You gotta play it slower, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I got. Okay. Rewind.
Is that it?
The beginning's weird. Don't trust me, I know.
We'll play it once it gets to the chorus.
Okay. Wait a second.
She gets a lot of her music taste from Moth Duck. Here's a chorus. Yes, there you go, Little Bad Wolf. It's Elton John, right? Piano Man.
Okay, but yeah, woo!
Yes, Piano Man.
I got a challenge for myself.
Little Bad Wolf. Okay. Little Bad Wolf got it. Time in a Bottle. No, she should learn that one, though, Yasmina. I don't think I've ever heard her play the Time in the Bottle song before. Every time I hear Piano Man, I think about the meme that was going around. It was one of those little play school pianos, little, you know, colorful red and blue, green plastic pianos, and it was a possum behind it, and it says, you know, it's like, play me a song, Mr. Piano Man.
Okay.
Little possum playing the piano. Okay, next song.
Okay,
go ahead.
I'm working on it.
That's pretty easy.
This is the first time I'm learning this.
No, I'm saying it's pretty easy to recognize this one.
You already know what it is?
Yeah, I can tell what it is. From a Disney movie, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Whatever, you know the beginning. You know the beginning.
Play the first few keys again.
Okay, give me a second.
Okay.
Come on, piano rap. The drunk version.
I see. Little Bad Wolf and Sassy both got it at the same time.
Woo!
Little Bad Wolf said the Little Mermaid.
Ooh, can I play this one? Please, real quick. This is one of my favorite ones that I know well.
I see. We have a whole pot of different, a whole lot of different music tastes around our family. And she gets it from everyone. She's just around me too much. She gets influenced.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, she learns, like, all the unique stuff that none of the other family members have heard or whatever. Like, she picks up, you know, she has her own, it really is her own taste. Like, she has definitely got a unique taste. So
course.
Whoop, that was the wrong octave. You give it up on that one?
No. We can get ready.
Okay. Here we go again with this one. Just the two. There you go. Little Bad Wolf. Okay, so Little Bad Wolf has. So Yasmina has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Seth has 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to try Mama Sonata for the first time. I want to try it.
5, 6. Well, hold on. Let's tell everybody bye.
No.
So, Little Bad Wolf, you won. I will get in contact with you to see if you'd rather have a painting or an Amazon card.
I can
do one song. Yasmina was right behind you.
I have one thing I want to do. I really want to do one more thing.
What?
Said I could do the last song.
Oh, last song? Oh, okay, so she wants to play a song. Like, if you have earbuds in, turn your volume down. But this is like a challenge song she's been working on for 6 months. I'll play this song, and then I'll go ahead and close out. Thank you for everyone for coming in. If you can hit that like, and if you haven't subscribed, but I think everybody's subscribed. Thank you for being here.
I'm standing up.
Too much Disney for me. Yeah, Yasmina. The last one was just the two of us song.
Okay, ready? This is like a song I've been working on.
We'll have to do this again. Getting faster and faster and faster.
Look up Rush E if you want to hear the actual good version.
Rush E. All right, well, thank you everybody for being here tonight, and I will see you next time. Next time we're going to cover some crystals, and she will practice more songs, and she's going to be practicing, what was that, Justin Bieber?
Yes.
For
and
Mr.
Dolly FU. Parton. I really want to do Dolly Parton now.
And any Andy Gibb song for Little Bad Wolf. But... Yeah. Take a painting? Okay, awesome. Little Bad Wolf wants a painting for you. Okay, so Little Bad Wolf will get in contact with you and see what you want a painting of. But everyone, I hope you have a blessed night and a safe weekend, and I will see y'all around.
Bye! Bye.